Hi everybody, I'm Kelly. Thank you for coming by my channel, and thank you for your time in watching this video. Now, in the not too distant past, I sent out a few little bits of envelopes and tags to various people. So if you recognize these, you might know what I'm talking about. This is 32-pound paper. It is not cardstock. It's tougher than printer, but not quite as firm as cardstock. And I'm going to try an experiment to do some napkin decoupage. So let's see how that goes. Okay, so here's some supplies you need. I always have this ironing pad. Sorry, I'm not exactly in frame. Ooh, there we go. This stays here permanently in my craft room. I borrowed one of the cutting boards from the kitchen to have a nice surface to put it on. I have a silicone mat here. My husband ordered me one from Amazon. I have some in the kitchen, but they're already nasty and greasy, and I don't want that anywhere near any crafty things. And you also need plastic wrap. I also have my iron turned on to a low setting without any steam. When you are doing decoupage with napkins, you only need the first ply. So I already took it apart. Now, because this has some white on it, I kind of fussy cut around it just to make sure it's in the right spot. And since I want to fold the little envelope in like this, I'm going to put it on the back. So unfortunately, the inside is going to be white. I suppose I could try to dye it or paint it or something, but that's going to be another experiment down the road. So I kind of want it to be like that, essentially, so that it gets all color and not any white stuff. Make sense? Okay. Looks kind of weird, doesn't it? And my apologies, you also need some parchment paper. So, the theory goes, we'll see if this works, is I've put my envelope down, how I want to, that's the side I want to stick to, and I put the plastic wrap over top, and it's all smooth. And the plastic wrap sticks down to the silicone pad so it doesn't go all shifty and messy on you. We'll see. Okay? So then your piece of napkin goes on how you want it. Or, I guess, maybe I could try to use fabric even. I don't know if it would bend good enough. We'll see. Maybe just for tags or something? It's a possibility. Might play with that. We'll see how the video goes. Okay, so pretty much, that is how I want it. Now, here's where the parchment comes into play. Because you don't want the iron sticking to the plastic wrap. Put it down carefully so that don't shift your napkin around. Now, if you have one of those little mini craft irons, it would probably come in great. I have an itty bitty little clover one. It's only really for doing turning applique edges. It would be completely useless for this, so I just went with my big one. So let's assume that that's stuck down and not moving around, and we'll see how we go. Don't move your iron side to side. Just lift it up, just so you don't move your napkin around. Oh, I guess we'll find out. And the theory is that the plastic wrap melts up and sticks your napkin to whatever you're trying to stick it to. And then to seal it up after, you Mod Podge it. So I guess we'll find out if this works or not. I have no idea how long I have to do this for. Let's just take the parchment back and look. Oh, it's not bad. Maybe down there, actually. Hold on. Well, you might have done this. I have never done this before, so you guys are doing it with me right now. If it works, great. If it doesn't, ah well. I'll still put the video up. Those of you who had been around my channel long enough, you know I'm an honest person, and you get me, warts and all. Okay. That's actually not too bad. I think I just need to do the edges a bit more. Hold on here. Yeah, it's sticking relatively good. All right, let me keep trying it and see how it works. Maybe this Costco plastic wrap isn't good. I don't know. This is the only plastic wrap I got, so that's what I'm using. Leave it in place for a few minutes, a few seconds longer, I mean. Sorry about this, guys. Maybe it's going to take longer. Smooth it out. Maybe I'll bump the heat up just a tad. See if that helps. Maybe. Go this way. I'm pretty sure that no steam is probably a good thing. Because that probably would be bad news. Let's see. Move that around. Have a look. Oh, it's not bad, actually. It's not great. I don't know. It didn't really stick down, though. That's weird. Okay, I wonder why. Okay, try and plan B. Now, duh me, obviously, you gotta have the napkin facing up. But it didn't seem to stick. So I cranked my heat on my iron up. I held it down really long just to make sure the plastic was melting. I watched the video originally again that I watched before to learn how to do this. And she said to let it cool really good. I did that. Nada. Now, the lady that I watched, her name is Joan Marie Domino, and she does lots of decoupage. So I will link the video for you guys. Forget if I said that anyway. Whatever. You know me, blah, blah, blah. She used cardstock. So, I don't know. I'm going to just give it a go. Maybe it depends the kind of paper. Anyway, so it's down on my mat. Now, the silicone mat she has are those dark red ones, which is what I have in the kitchen, and it's disgustingly filthy. So, I'm hoping that this one works. I mean, one would think a silicone mat's a silicone mat, right? I don't know. So, I'm just trying this out. I'm not actually making a project. I'm just seeing if the freaking thing's going to work. Okay, trying with parchment this time. Cardstock this time, and we'll see what happens. Your guess is as good as mine, everybody. I want to get iron on over there on the plastic. Maybe because cardstock's stiffer, it sticks better? I don't know. But I'm also, like, sitting it for a few seconds, like, making the iron really hot, right? I got it cranked right up, too. Okay, it has kind of a smell to it now, but it did that before too, so I don't know. This video might be a dud. All right, let's see. All right, everybody. I don't know about this. I think it kind of worked. If you watch the video, I'm going to link to this. Jo Marie just basically picks her card up, the whole thing, and it comes up and leaves the plastic wrap sitting there with a hole in it where it's all got stuck. Well, I can't do that. If I try to pick this up, it will come off. Like, I can kind of jiggle it up. It's not bad, but I lift it up, and it all comes with. So, it is kind of stuck down. I mean, it's not awful. It's not great on the edges, though. So I don't know if I can actually use it for something that has to go right to the edge, or if I have to just do the best I can. Because it's kind of stuck down in the middle. So, if I do something like that and then I cut around it and, like, Mod Podge and cut it, like, I don't really know. I don't know what to tell you guys anymore. I don't know if this method works or not. Unless I just buy some El Cheapo plastic wrap, I suppose. I don't know. Maybe that Costco stuff is too stiff or something. Anyway, well, leave it at that for right now. And I'd love an opinion from everybody because I'm kind of not impressed with this. Let me all know what you think.